My name is Jacqueline Velez, and I go to school at UCF, majoring in aerospace engineering.
I really like trigonometry. I love trigonometry and chemistry, which is what I'm taking now. Like physics, quantum physics is awesome.
My name is Swanee Duran, and I go to the University of Central Florida. My major is psychology. I'm interested in psychology because I find it very fascinating that every personality is different and how the brain works in a variety of ways between different people.
My name is Camila Mivero, and I'm an assistant professor. I'm a specialty in microbiology and molecular biology. My favorite thing about biology, everything that we think we know, we don't know a lot about it just yet. Even though science has been around for many decades and hundreds of years, we keep learning new things every single day. I don't think we have everything figured out, and I don't know if we ever will.
Yeah, actually, I was thinking about becoming a psychiatrist. That is in my plan right now, but things can change. I want to be able to prescribe medicine. It's a higher degree, and it pays more. It's not all about the money. It is actually about helping people.
Whenever I tell people my major, they're like surprised. That's the biggest reaction I always get. They're like, wow, you like math and science, that's so weird.
I believe that I'm part of a women's group at UCF of professors or staff that also are going through anything like this, and we can discuss it. So I don't think it's something that's specific to my department or my college. It is something that happens in the whole university level, and it probably is something that happens throughout the nation as well. Some of the ladies that are in that group have come from different institutions that have seen the same thing happen there as well. So I don't believe it is a independent and variable. I think we all have this problem throughout the country, and hopefully it's something again that we can fix. We are women, we are smart, and we should be just, you know, seen as such instead of the weaker sex or not as important.
I find that there are more male professors for psychology, and I've met more male psychology majors as students at UCF.
I feel like it's worse in different countries, and I don't know about in different parts of the United States, but I haven't really experienced like any negativity.
As a woman in general, I feel like we do have a little bit of a boys club out there. Being a female, a young female, assistant professor in all my position, I do feel sometimes secluded from conversations, secluded from what we are doing as a department or as a division. My voice sometimes I feel like it's weak in comparison. But hopefully it's something that we can work together to fix. At the moment, I do feel like I'm sitting in the corner of the table and not being heard or not being recognized.
Like, women are raised to live the domestic life of cooking and cleaning. They're handed a doll, they're handed toys at Barbies with like a kitchen playhouse. Men are handed cars, mechanical things, like tools.
In most other careers, I would say that women are portrayed rather negatively against men, but in psychology, I think women are perceived a little bit more nurturing and a little more fit for the job because of that nurturing, mothering characteristic that this female stereotype holds. I do feel like I have a lot of empathy. It's a curse more than a blessing because I can feel too much of what other people are going through.
My mother is a nurse. She works at like a trauma, in a hospital at the trauma bay. And my dad works in Colombia in a business that his dad started, but he used to be a pilot, so I guess I've always had that influence, like a flying, and that's what influenced aerospace engineering.
Oh, my parents absolutely inspired me. My mother was an architect and a psychiatrist. She was a very strong woman who wanted to go to school, even though her dad said no. She kept going with her mom's help. And my dad was a chemist and major in business. So being in a science family, from the time I was a kid, I wanted a chemistry kit to play around the pool. So definitely my parents and, you know, helped me figure out where I wanted to go.
My mom is a charge nurse for the cardiovascular intensive care unit. And my dad is he was a jeweler, but throughout the years he's gotten a little bit more into real estate and stuff like that, but he still continues to make jewelry. Real estate's like his little hobby.
matter how many people tell you that it's a boys thing or how many people tell you that it's going to be difficult. It's absolutely difficult. It is hard. It is sometimes disheartening. But you are strong and you can do this if this is what you want to do. Don't ever let anybody tell you different, especially if you are a girl or because you have this or that. Just do it. It's the best thing you can do is prove them wrong. And when you do, you can say, I told you so.
I would say to just break all restraints that define you as a woman. Like, let's help dad. Just break all the things that say you're a woman and, like, just do whatever you like. Get your interests and dig deep into them. And then what you learn will stick with you forever because it's what you're passionate about.